Ever wonder who the coolest, slickest, hottest promotion out in Vancouver is?
Have you ever wondered who God's gift to wrestling is?
Have you ever wondered what company in Western Canada sent more stars to the WWE in the last 10 years?
Have you also ever wondered who's been the most active in training indie superstars but yet still remains in the ring?
Those questions and more will be answered in Gutbuster TV. Hey wrestling fans, my name's T. James Logan. I fell in love with wrestling when I was 9 years old. That's 36 years now that I've spent watching wrestling from all over the world.
Hey, and my name's Otto Allen. I've been watching wrestling at a young age, hanging out in arenas, watching Stampede Wrestling. Took a break for a number of years and caught an indie show and have fell in love with it ever since.
We endeavor to scour the world of indie wrestling to find you the best action, the best stars, and the best companies out there. These indie companies tend to be the breeding ground for the big time. Maybe we're gonna find the next Hulk Hogan, maybe the next Stone Cold Steve Austin, maybe the next AJ Styles. All we do know is we're gonna find wrestlers who are gonna leave an imprint on you. We're gonna find companies that are gonna get you excited, and we're gonna make you fall in love with indie wrestling the same way we have.
Our first promotion that we're going to look at today is Real Canadian Wrestling, or RCW, the first place we actually met at.
You know what? Real Canadian Wrestling. Yeah, we met there, and it started our journey together, finding more and more wrestling companies that we enjoy.
Absolutely.
Now, do you know much about RCW?
Hey, I'm a big fan of RCW. Comes to my hometown once a month. I'm always there, front row, bells whistling, streamers throwing. I'm always there for a good time.
Well, you know, RCW is probably one of the more active companies in the indie world right now.
That's right.
They continuously have shows all across Alberta, sometimes reaching into even Saskatchewan. They're a showcase of great local wrestlers and their own based wrestlers. And today we're going to look at one of their hometowns versus one of the guys that they have been bringing in quite a bit. And I'm talking about an international superstar in the name of Jesse Neal. Now, Jesse Neal is a former TNA wrestler who he lit the world on fire with his very unique look and his daredevil style. Folks, you'll look at him, you'll see a guy with a mohawk and tattoos, and you yep. might think he's the punk rocker, but he's not. We're talking about a former military guy who's very proud of his Native American heritage, hence the mohawk, and he is just a guy who lives on the edge and wrestles.
He's got no limits at all.
No limits. I mean, one time in Festival Hall, did we not see this guy jump off a 20-foot balcony?
Banister, yeah.
Oh, man. And onto a guy.
Yep.
Well, he's going to be going up against one of the great home talents of RCW, and that's Scott Justice. Scott Justice, who, former Storm Graduate Academy,
yep.
Australian. Here's a guy who has toured extensively across Western Canada, fighting guys left and right. He's a former Commonwealth champion. As we sit here right now, I do believe he is the RCW
Heavyweight Champion.
Went through a tournament.
Absolutely.
Faced some tremendous competition. Well, tonight, we get these two guys. They're all about smash mouth, all about jumping off the top rope. They're all about dazzling you and taking your breath away. Here are two guys who not only don't seem to like gravity, but they don't like each other. So let's take a look at Scott Justice and Jesse Neal.
Taste of gold!
Fans, let's take a look now at one of the individual wrestlers that we're going to be highlighting. Today, we're going to be highlighting a guy who I can only describe as a veteran and a workhorse. I'm talking about Tornado Tony Cozzino.
Hey, wasn't he an NWA former junior champion?
Yes, he was.
And he even trained Davey Richards.
I know, this is a guy of tremendous skill and tremendous potential all around for everything. And right now, Tony's going to be touring with New Japan International. He'll be headed down to New Zealand. He's going to be sending us some stuff in the upcoming weeks. But we want to take a little spotlight on Tornado Tony Cozzino and show you what the buzz is about him.
Year after year, I travel the globe. I travel North America looking for the best competition because that's what makes you a better professional wrestler. And when you're talking about the best, the very best in independent professional wrestling, there's one name that you need to know. There's one name that you need to be familiar with, and that name is Cozzino. And there must be some truth to what I'm doing because it's been nearly 20 glorious years and I continue to travel around. I continue to face the very best on the biggest stages, the biggest shows, the biggest cities. I travel everywhere. So when you see my name on the marquee, you know you're getting your money's worth. And if you're standing across the ring from me, fellas, no matter where you are, when I come to your area, and believe me, I'll get to your area sooner or later. I always do. You better be at your very best, because I'm always at mine. It's been nearly 20 glorious years, and I continue to travel around. I continue to face the very best.
Fans, the next company we're going to look at is a company that's very dear to my heart. When I said that I've been a wrestling fan for 36 years, I neglected to say how I really deeply started getting into indie wrestling itself 9 years ago. All because I one day accidentally walked into a show featuring stars from the Prairie Wrestling Alliance. From that day forth, I became a regular fan of the PWA, and I continued to follow them so much so that we created Gutbuster Radio that helped us develop and showcase what PWA was about, but it also expanded into other venues, including the venue you're seeing right now of Gutbuster TV. So let's take a look at Prairie Wrestling Alliance. Located out of Edmonton, Alberta, the City of Champions, Prairie Wrestling Alliance has been around for 15 years, and they have showcased, not only have they showcased big names, Otto, but they have had wrestlers, and I could name quite a few, who have gone on from being regular stablemates there and gone on to the big time, into WWE itself. I'm talking about Tyler Breeze.
Yep.
I'm talking about APOC from The Ascension. Tyler Kidd. Harry Smith, or the British Bulldog Jr. Natalya Neidhart. The list goes on. I mean, Jinder Mahal. So many great wrestlers who have come through the PWA, have excited the fans, and then brought it to the big leagues. Well, the PWA is still continuing that trend and still working and showing us some great stuff. I mean, they've got some great wrestlers coming up. But today, we're going to look at two of the top names.
They are the top names.
They are the top names. One is the champion.
Yep. The PWA original, Markey, facing off against MRB Michael Richard Blaze.
And Michael Richard Blaze definitely, in my mind, has to be the premier wrestler in Western Canada at
Absolutely.
The moment. Although, I'm not putting down any of these other companies. I just think that I would love to see him also in other companies wrestling. But let's take a look at this match where we see the PWA champion taking on Michael Richard Blaze. The belt was not even on stakes here. This was a meeting of two guys who've been in the same company for many years. They haven't fought each other in a very long time. Especially, I think this is what they told me, is the first time in a main event for them. And it was phenomenal. These two guys took it to each other really hard. But you know what? The PWA champion, the original Mark, he was on his ball tonight. But keep an eye on that Michael Richard Blaze.
Welcome, wrestling fans, to the premiere edition of PWA Wrestling on Gutbuster TV. My name is Big Bad Boris. Thank you for joining us. This time around, we are going to feature some action from the PWA's annual Halloween extravaganza, PWA Fright Night. The main event of Fright Night featured a non-title match between the PWA champion Markey and Michael Richard Blaze. Blaze turning his back on Markey at the aforementioned PWA 15th anniversary show. These two athletes are two of the best PWA has to offer. Quite frankly, two of the best Canada has to offer. Let's go to the closing moments of this matchup, your main event of PWA Fright Night 2016. Picks up the victory in a definite match of the year candidate. Since this match, I've spoken with both of these two men and they are both hurting, both men not the same after that crazy battle at Fright Night. That's going to do it for this first edition of PWA Wrestling featured on Gutbuster TV. I want to thank those guys for having us involved in this project. You can see us live November 5th, 2016 in Calgary for Remembrance. And our final event of 2016 will take place in Edmonton, Alberta. PWA Christmas Slam featuring Cody Rhodes taking on Michael Richard Blaze. Tickets are on sale now. They are going fast. For all of the information on the Prairie Wrestling Alliance, check us out online, our website, pwawrestling.ca. We are on all of the social media. Thank you for joining us. On behalf of everybody in the PWA, my name is Big Bad Boris, and we will see you next time here on Gutbuster TV.
Hey, Otto, check this out, man. Hoodies from Squared Circle.
I love it. You know what I even like better? Check it out, the hats. They've got everything you need in apparel here at Squared Circle.
Hey, everyone. Our next wrestler we're going to look at is Jude Dawkins from the CWC, currently the heavyweight champion.
Is he not the cheetah bear, I believe they
call
him?
That's right, the cheetah bear.
And let's explain, what is the cheetah bear? Here's a guy who's big, burly, but he has that explosive start like a cheetah straight out the blocks. We're talking about a guy who's, he may be an up-and-comer, he may be not that long in the business, but he's definitely got an upside like you would not believe. We're talking power, we're talking strength, and we're talking enthusiasm. And boy, you know, the crowd really loves him because this guy really is out there fighting the good fight. Let's take a look at this guy.
Hey Jude, don't make it bad.
Oh! Hey everyone, welcome to Gutbuster TV. With me as always,
the legend T. James Logan.
And me, Otto Allen. Hey, we're backstage. We've got a late, great announcement and an extra addition to our video.
Obviously, we're all about exclusives, and we have a great exclusive coming in from the state of Hawaii.
Yes.
Now, this video that was sent to us by a team calling themselves the Polynesian Power Trip, and this tag team is incredible. Tell us a little bit about the model.
Well, they got Audie Van Loo, who's like a giant beast.
And Kaimana, who, well, let's face it, he's an even bigger beast. We're talking about two angry Polynesian guys who, as you're going to see in this video, are as intimidating as all. And we had no choice but to show you. Sorry it's late. We couldn't get it into the show because the show is in post-production right now. But here's an exclusive from Gutbuster TV.
We go across the country over to the Vancouver area where we have another great solid company. I mean, these guys are making a name for themselves in the indie world. I'm talking about the Eli Canadian Championship Wrestling, ECCW. Founded by Scotty Mack many years ago, this company is producing some of the best superstars in the indie world and guys who I definitely think are on the radar of the WWE.
All right, folks, you won't believe the footage that we have from this promotion. This is a match that made me honestly want to get into my car and drive all the way down and see it in person. Thomas, why don't you tell us a little bit about these two guys?
This was some exciting stuff. El Fantasmo, this guy, you know, when I first met this guy, I wasn't sure what to think. El Fantasmo reads to me like a Mexican mask guy. But instead, there was this very cocky, brash young fellow, doesn't wear a mask, and he flies like a Mexican
Absolutely.
Wrestler. And mix his arrogance in with, he's equal amounts arrogance, equal amounts skill, and it's very high level. And then you get a guy like PWG's Brian Cage. This is a guy who's touring across most of the United States. He's been in Lucha Underground. He showcased himself as a very powerful, and when you see the build on this guy and the power moves he does in this match, it is a clash of egos for sure, as we had two wrestlers, no belts on the line here. This is for bragging rights, you know. ECCW had showcased the feud between these guys for very long. Neither of these guys wanted to walk away as champion. They wanted to walk away with the hey, I beat you. And here we have just this tremendous match. El Fantasmo versus Brian Cage. Folks, we're not even going to do anything more blabbing about it because this is the kind of stuff that indie wrestling is all about.
Important to hire the best team to enable you to reach your customers and share your story. Starting at the planning and development stage and working through to the finished product, Brass Media Canada uses the latest and leading-edge technology and the top talent in their field to bring your message to the internet. You can find us on the web at www.brassmedia.ca.
Fans, we have a chance now to talk to a, I'm going to call him a definitely a legend in professional wrestling, especially out here in Western Canada. A lot of people know the name Cowboy Dan Crawford. Dan, you had a remarkable career, not only in Stampede Wrestling, but across the wrestling world.
I appreciate that introduction. Obviously, you know, I've never for a moment, allowed myself to think that I was one of the true superstars, because there were so many guys who contributed so much to the business. But you know what? I had the very good fortune of being in the industry during a time that was very special. And it's kind of nice now to reflect on those days.
Well, you know, you're remembered for a lot of things. You're remembered for the ladder match, a match that I believe that you were instrumental in creating.
Yeah, I put that together in the early 70s. I was working with a guy named Toru Kamada, about a 300-pound Japanese fellow, and I had talked to Stu Hart about bringing an idea to the table. I thought about the stepladder being put in the ring and hanging money and then eventually the belt. He liked the idea and he gave me the green light and said, yeah, go ahead with it. So, you know what? History shows what it is. They use it today in the WWE on a very regular basis, and it's probably generated millions of dollars for Vince, but unfortunately it didn't generate those kind of monies for me. But you know what? I get great pleasure and pride out of thinking I made a contribution to the industry.
Well, you know what? One feud you're particularly remembered for, especially out here in Western Canada, was your ongoing problems with the Stomper, Archie Goldie. Tell us a little bit about the history that you guys had together.
You know, it was a natural chemistry. I think of Al Pacino and Robert De Niro working in movies together. I think they had a natural chemistry. And I had worked with a lot of great names in the business, and many of them were, you know, terrific workers and really nice guys. But Archie had something special, and, you know, he had a reputation of being one tough critter, and he was, all of those things. But also, he was a businessman. You know, I proposed ideas to him about, you know, telling stories and coming back week after week, and the chemistry was just there. It worked. So, you know what, I look back at him. He was very instrumental in helping me sort of, proceed in my career. And I think he was truly a great legend. He was iconic. And even in today, he would have fit into the WWE with his personality and his working skills.
Now, you know what? You faced him many times. Describe what a match was like being in there with the Stomper.
I think it was all about conditioning. Like, he was in tremendous condition. So sometimes if we had to go 30 minutes or 45 minutes, I found myself tested somewhat. You know, I would make sure that, you know, I tried to keep up to him. And then when you're selling an idea or a concept, you know, it's going through your mind that not only physically do you have to keep up with this guy, but you also have to consider you're telling a story. So you're working on two things, conditioning and storytelling.
How long was your career? From what year did you start wrestling to what year did you finish?
Yeah, I started in 69 and I finished up in about 85. I had the great pleasure of doing a sellout show in Calgary in a double main event with Hulk Hogan against King Kong Bundy and myself and the Honky Tonk Man, and that was in the Saddle Dome. We had well over 20,000 people there, and you know what, I thought to myself, this is a time to pack it in when you're on top and you're enjoying the business. And I got out of the business physically well. You know, I didn't carry injuries and I never messed with any of the drugs, the steroids, or any of that stuff. Obviously, I didn't have the great size, or if I had, I would have been messing with the drugs, but I didn't. And so I had a good career. I was very fortunate.
Now, I know one thing that I've talked with you many times, that one of the things you're passionate about is trying to impress on the younger wrestlers today of the future that finishes wrestling, that there's more to life than wrestling.
To me, there's a couple things that are primary with young wrestlers today, and if this message can be conveyed and it could help just one person, I would feel great about it. Is that the world of pro wrestling, think of it as a small window, like a porthole in a ship. But when you think of life, it's like a picture window in a house. There's so much to live. And quite frankly, if people are not prepared or planning to exit wrestling at some time in their lives, then it becomes much harder in the journey after. So I always propose and talk about the fact of having plan B. You know, find a career, get involved with business, get involved in the community. I've spent nearly 25 years in community engagement, fundraising, charity work, you know, and I'd love to do it. So you will, you know, by doing these things, by planning your exit, it really affords you the ability to pass on things like depression, sadness, loneliness. I mean, there's a lot of guys out there suffering not only financially, but emotionally. they're having a tough time too, because they've gone from the stardom to becoming just a common citizen, and quite often that's a very tough transition.
Tell me right now, what charities are you involved in? What's really passionate going on in your life right now?
Oh my goodness, you know, it's funny you should ask now. I've been involved for the last 25 years in so many, and working with children's groups and fundraisers, but I'm working on one in particular right now that's extremely important, and I thank you for asking the question. Last year found that a lot of the poppy boxes were being stolen in Calgary, so I decided to go out and redesign a brand new poppy box that was sort of theft-proof, if you will. So I spent a year doing that and got tremendous support, and I've now got 50 boxes distributed in Cochrane, Alberta, and we're test running them out there, and I hope that we can protect the veterans' money, because what I've also learned is that thousands and thousands of veterans are living below the poverty line, and hundreds of veterans are living on the streets. So if we can secure the monies that go into these poppy boxes, and the new box I've designed is pretty safe, and hopefully people will donate more money towards the cause, because it is supporting our veterans who will really make our lives as good as they are. So it's our way of showing appreciation.
Thank you for taking the time to talk to us, and we look forward to talking to you down the road and finding out the wonderful community service you're doing and hear a little bit more about your insight into wrestling.
I always look forward to talking to you. I hope your program is a real success. I believe it will be, and I hope a lot of your viewers and listening audience are the people who have supported wrestling over the years, and I want to thank them, because obviously I wouldn't have had a career if it wasn't for the fans and the support. So to all your listening audience and your viewing audience, thank you so much for your support over the years.
Now we're going to transition from what was an established promotion to one of the most up-and-coming new promotions here in Central Alberta, CWC, the Canadian Wrestling Coalition. Locally based, owned and operated, these guys have done everything. They built their own ring from start to scratch. They've got something great they're starting, and we're happy to have them on our show today.
You know what? They may be a new company, but they're really bringing in fans all across Central Alberta. We'd be remiss not to talk to them and look at them, and today, very interesting matchup. Almost a battle of companies, as the CWC champion, Jude Dawkins, you know, this is his first title defense, and talk about a title defense, facing the provincial champion from another company, Dean Richter. In here we're going to see the classic matchup of a young, exuberant powerhouse taking on a wily veteran. Dean Richter, here's a guy who's been around for, well, he's taken a good 10 years off, but he's back again with a vengeance. He does know the veteran moves. He does know the insight. But Jude Dawkins, you've seen this guy. Power. Tell me a bit about the Cheetah Bear, man.
All right, let's talk about the Cheetah Bear. Known other than Jude Dawkins. The man is built like a tank. Big beard. He's got the power, the strength, the athleticism to take any match to any level. Folks, I am excited to see him. I was excited to see him my first time I got to watch him. I can't wait for you guys to see this match.
Now here we're going to see a veteran versus up-and-comer. What kind of game do they use? Well, Jude Dawkins, the upcomer, he is definitely all power and strength. Dean Richter, a lot of technical and a lot of sneaky things. Take a look here. Jude, two great knees. You know what he's going to follow it up with?
Hey, another knee. Look at this one. Highly executed.
Notice the attack.
Oh man. Ouch.
Richter cheating as, well, he can do, and trying to be brutal.
The stomps. He's bringing them back. Some vicious elbows there. Oh, lights out for Jude on that move.
Jude trying to be too fancy, got caught with a veteran move. And of course, the cheating by Colonel Austin. You know this is what Dean Richter's strength is. He's going to keep trying to get in as many things as he can. He's not as big as Jude.
That's right, legend.
Now look at this.
Jude, and miss.
Jude too quick to try and get in his power move. Didn't watch himself. Ate a forearm. And now eating a suplex. I want to point out, though, if you notice, Dean's not exactly attacking the same body parts a lot, which I think might be a bit of his downfall here.
That's right.
Going after the head, go after the back, go after the knees. Meanwhile, if you notice, Jude is centering his attack basically on the midsection.
That's right. It looks like Jude's really trying to use the crowd to his advantage here, hometown, cheering him on.
Well, and another thing I want to point out, I think Dean may have actually underestimated his opponent, because he's getting that look on his face. You can see right here,
a look of desperation. He didn't really think that Jude would be able to go this long with him. I think he thought it was going to be an easier night. This is the first defense.
Nice reversal.
This is the first defense of Jude's title. So, you know, he is fairly new in championship rings.
That's right.
Oh, the veteran misses, but shows you what happens.
Here's another knee. A DDT.
Now, you see the problem I have with that?
Look at Jude now.
Great move, but knee to the head.
That's right.
Dean, you got to keep going for the same part. Jude is consistent. He keeps going for the same body part. Dean seems like he's getting a little desperate and trying to pull out any move that he thinks can throw his opponent off. You've hit him three times in the head, and now you're going to go for a suplex? I've got to wonder about that. Why not go for some kind of knee drop, some kind of thing to bring him on his head, not on his back? But exuberance and power in youth. That's what Jude is... He's using his power seat to hold down Dean.
That's right. Here we go. A reversal.
But Dean...
There we go with the power bomb.
Jude, some great stuff there. I mean, once again, where does he hit? Back and lower back. Stomach area.
Colonel there, again, interrupting with the match. Jude, he's got to take care of this right now, as far as I'm concerned.
You got to deal with the Colonel because, I mean, I don't even know why the referee just doesn't get him out of there. He's been interfering enough. He's touched the referee. He's touched wrestlers. Get him out. But you know what? Unfortunately, Jude, young guy, does not think ahead. Of course the advantage is going to turn to Dean when you're spending too much time going after the Colonel. Now, this is where I started wondering maybe Dean was trying to go for a more attack on the head now. Last couple moves, he's been attacking the face, he's been attacking the head area.
That's right.
And this is a brilliant move for a veteran right here. You've got him upside down, go for that head.
Oh, man, baseball slide. Vicious baseball slide to the head.
Oh.
And he's taunting the fans afterwards.
But, once again, what does Jude bring us? Strength. Look at that.
Look at that power.
Just tosses him out like he's nothing. And then, a bit of a surprise for me, going a little bit Mexican style.
Wait, wait for this. So this is my favorite part of the match right here. This is classic Jude Dawkins. Right there.
He does really know how to get the crowd behind him. And look at this. You know, just out of Mexico City type move. Just a dive
big
through.
Big splash. He's loving it.
Right now, the youthfulness of Jude Dawkins has really got him pumped. He's really looking for his stuff. And what does he do? Continuous tacks on the head and fall with a shining wizard. What a great move at this time. Dean's really got to be feeling desperate here.
But he's still there, though. The veteran comes back. Oh, look at that spear.
Power move right to the stomach again. Once again, the stomach, lower back area. Jude's consistent in his attack. And sort of a follow-away slam here.
Could this be it, though, folks? One, two, three for the win. There he is, folks. Your reigning CWC champion, Jude Dawkins, with a victory.
Over the provincial champion.
That's right.
What a great match. Once again, showing strength and persistence. Always go for the same area of attack, folks. You're not going to win if you try and attack somebody in every aspect.
There's your champion, CWC. Jude Dawkins.
Finally, the last wrestler we're going to look at today is probably, I'm going to say, one of the best talents I've seen in a very long time. I'm talking about Michael Richard Blaze. Here is a breakout star in Western Canada who should be breaking out. Why? Why is this guy not in the WWE? I don't know.
No idea.
Now, you've seen him, Otto. You've seen this guy fight many times.
Well, he comes right out and he's bold. He calls himself hashtag match of the night. And I'm sorry, he is the match of the night in every single location. I've had a chance to see his high-flying antics, his high kicks. He's fought the best of the best from all over the world. Folks, check him out.
Who is God's gift to wrestling? He's a man that was born with the drive to be better than everybody else. He was not born with natural talent, but he has acquired it by working harder than all the rest. He is a man that makes things that most people think are impossible, possible. He is a man that does things you only wish you could. He is a man who sets goals that for the rest of the world are just dreams. And he accomplishes them. My name is Michael Richard Blaze. And everything I just listed is exactly what I am. Because I am God's gift to wrestling.
And we're back. We're going to take a look now at the CWE, the Canadian Wrestling Elite, located in where? It's Manitoba, I believe,
Winnipeg, Manitoba. Created by hotshot Danny Duggan, one of the, it's got to be Central Canada's most well-known promotion.
Absolutely.
They bring up guys from ROH, and they have so many independent wrestlers coming in all over North America. They've also been on constant tours, even going so far as coming into Saskatchewan and Alberta, and running shows semi-regularly. Today, we're going to be looking at some exciting action from them, and we're going to see why exactly they are the Elite of Central Canada.
Greetings, grappling fans! This is the most heart-stopping, jaw-dropping, eye-popping, high-flying, death-defying, awe-inspiring wrestler in the world today, Jason the Gift Kincaid, and you're tuning in to CWE Adrenaline!
Thank you, folks, for watching. It's been great showing all the stuff on Gutbuster TV. We're here for you. and we're going to be scouring the world of indie wrestling, trying to find companies, trying to find wrestlers. You know what? If you're a fan and you're watching this and you think you know a wrestler who deserves to be highlighted, if you're a company and you're saying, why isn't my company sitting there? I have some great wrestling. Send us this information. Otto, tell them where they can send our stuff.
Well, first of all, you can check us out on Facebook. You can check us out on Instagram and Twitter. As well as if you want to send us an email, you can send us an email at gutbustermedia@gmail.com. But most importantly, like us right here on YouTube, where you can see more of us coming to see you.
You know what? Gutbuster Television has been a great time. We're only going to build it the more that you want to see things, fans. Tell us what you want to see. Maybe you're not a company or a wrestler. Send us an email anyways and say how much you like us, how much you loved me, how much you may not have liked Otto. I'm cool with that. But folks, we're here for you. So please, send in your emails. Get on the old Twitter and Instagram. I don't know. I'm a dinosaur. I'm not sure what that stuff means. But you know what? I do know indie wrestling. My name is T. James Logan. And I want to thank you for joining. And my co-host?
Hey, I'm Otto Allen. It's been a pleasure.